Hello everyone, welcome to Engineered Learnings. Engineered Learnings has been created as an effort to help and reach out to all the engineering students, aspirants and professionals out there with the basic understanding and the crux of the topics important for placements, vivas, semesters, competitive examinations and all types of interviews. So let's go to today's topic. Welcome everyone. So today we are off to discussing about a very interesting topic, that is adiabatic flame temperature. You would be often asked to calculate the adiabatic flame temperature in a semester examination or something like that. So as the name suggests, first we would start by writing the energy balance equation. If we write the energy balance equation, we would see that dE by dT is equals to H in minus H out, that is the enthalpy difference, plus Q minus W. That this W contains shaft work, electrical work and other works, and this Q is basically the heat exchange throughout the process. So as the name suggests, this is the adiabatic flame temperature. So it's an adiabatic process that's taking place. So firstly, this is Z. Moreover, the considerations, the assumptions here, WS is equal to 0, that is no shaft work is being done. No shaft work. So this is 0. So you see that if it is a steady state process, this is the second assumption, it's a steady state process. So this is again 0. So you see that H in minus H out is equals to 0, which means that H inlet is equals to H outlet. So for a particular process that's taking place, for a particular adiabatic process that's taking place, we see that supposedly this is my reactor, this is my control volume that we have defined in space, and this is my reactant 1, this is my reactant 2 that's entering, this is my product 1 and this is my product 2 that's exiting. This is my T outlet temperature and T inlet temperature. So this is my control volume. So this is my control volume. I'm writing it as control wall. And so we see that for this control volume, it is a steady state process. If the shaft work is there, or there is no shaft is there, and if the it is an adiabatic process, we see that H reactants is equals to H products, PDTS. H reactants is equals to H products, H in is equals to H out. So to find out T out, our motive is to find out T out, we do not know T out, that is the adiabatic flame temperature. So to find that out, we need to realize that the enthalpy at a particular state point, is nothing but the moles of that into the heat of formation at a particular temperature T plus Cp dT I Cpi dT from T to T0. Now let me explain this. It is quite deceptive at times for students. So what happens is, basically this is my reactant at state temperature T in. So we basically move down, that is we remove Q1 heat to reach a state point to where the temperature is T0. That is, we remove some heat to decrease the temperature to an intermediate state, that is the reference temperature. Supposedly it is 25 degrees Celsius. So we lose some heat and bring the inlet components to a temperature T0. Then we form the product. Then we move through the reaction and form a product at a constant temperature. That is, we follow an isothermal process. So T is equals to T0 here as well, but the products are formed. So the products are already being formed at T reference temperature. So this requires a Q2 amount of heat, supposedly. From supposedly A is A, R to P. So basically R to P takes Q2 amount of heat. And from R to intermediate stage, that is R intermediate, that is at 25 degrees Celsius from inlet temperature, Q1 amount of heat is being released. So to maintain an adiabatic process, it has to be given an amount of heat, Q1 plus Q2, this is the amount of heat that we need to give, so that it reaches a temperature T out, such that the overall heat balance, that is minus Q1, that is the amount of heat lost in this step, minus Q2, that is the amount of heat that is being required in this reaction state, and finally the amount of heat that is maybe released in the step, this is an exothermic process, considering it to be an exothermic process, and the amount of heat that you need to extract to bring it to this state. So this total amount of minus that is given from the system and given out from the system. Now this amount of heat is given inside the system. So plus Q1 plus Q2 amount of heat is given to the intermediate product at T0, that is product intermediate, and finally product final is formed. So you see the total amount of heat is abstained to zero. So this is an adiabatic process. So first what happens is reactant loses some amount of heat to come to reaction intermediate, then loses some amount of heat to undergo an exothermic reaction to form product intermediate, and then from product intermediate we are going back by gaining some amount of heat to product final. So you see, and that product final's temperature is T out, we need to calculate that. So coming to now this expression, for a particular state point, if we see that supposedly we are talking about a particular state point, that is the for the inlet products, if we see, we have a thing is that we consider the heat of formation. We supposedly know the heat of formation from R to P. We know that R to P is a reaction that undergoes, and the heat of formation at 25 degrees Celsius is supposedly known to us, is given, supposedly X or 10, maybe 15, whatever is known to us. But we do not know the heat of formation at maybe T in 80 degrees Celsius, supposedly. So what we do is, first we bring it to 25 degrees Celsius, so we lose some amount of it, that is we lose CpdT, that is from T in to T0. We lose, and then we lose another amount of heat, that is Ni into, that is the number of moles of this component into the heat of formation of that component. So basically what happens is for the inlet products, if we consider for all the products at once, I'm considering, that is H reactant is nothing but sigma Ni Hi, which is nothing but sigma Ni into, this is by the way whole bracket, so Ni Hi, so basically Ni into HF T0, that is T reference temperature, formation of heat formation, plus CpiDT, this is your individual components of HFI, from T in to T0. So for each component we need to calculate this. So if we know the T in, if we know the mole fraction of the number of moles of each compound, and if we know the heat of formation of each compound, then we can supposedly find out the final T out by again considering the H products to be similarly in I into, if I consider this HF T0 plus CpiDT integration of t naught to t out. So if we can find the expression of Cp in terms of t, and then we get an expression of in terms of t out being the only unknown, and we solve this equation by providing H reactant is equals to H product. So we equate these two equations together. We know the heat of formations at standard temperature. We bring them down to standard temperature. We know the CPI expression in terms of T. We know that Cp is A plus Bt plus Ct square plus Dt to the power cube to the power 3. So we know it for individual components. This A, B, C is going to change. For each reactant, supposing the reactant R contains A, B, C, D, these type of components. So each of A will have different A, 1, B, 1, C, 1, and D, 1. Each of A, B, C will have a different A. And that's why there will be an expression of Cp in terms of T, and there we will have to solve this to get a final expression in terms of T out. T out, we know that T in, we know that T reference, that is the T naught, we know the heat of formation at T naught, we know the individual moles. And what we have to equate this to find out that E out. So this is the final equation. We have to equate this. So you will be given a certain reactor, and you will be told that this is the amount of reactant that is coming, this is the amount of reactant that is going out. You will have to find the rest of the moles that are coming in by mole balance simply, and then you will have to go for energy balance equation to finally find out the adiabatic flame temperature, that is the outlet temperature of the product. And remember, you will have to scale down to make it a heat of formation approach. This is called the heat of formation approach. And heat of formation is always provided in standard notes at 25 degrees Celsius for at a reference temperature mentioned, particularly 25 degrees Celsius TREF. You will have to bring down the reactants to 25 degrees Celsius. You will have to calculate the amount of heat you have spent there. And then you will have to undergo the reaction at 25 degrees Celsius, consider the heat of formation, and then you will have to again bring the final product to the T outlet temperature, which is unknown to you, but you know that the amount of heat lost through the entire process will be zero, and then hence you can equate this to enthalpies to find out the value of T out. This is the way you can find out an adiabatic film temperature. So I guess that's it for today, and if you like the work, like it, share it with your friends, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.